no time.
Not.
How many of you want to exercise regularly but you have no time? Yeah, I agree. I'm sure all of us would have used at least once the phrase no time, right? At least one point or the other. Today I would like to share my experience of no time and my story as to what it taught me, what were the learnings that I learned from that no time phrase. One of my friends walked up to me and asked me if I could find 7 hours of time to train out for a triathlon. For people who do not know what is a triathlon, it is swimming, cycling and running. So it's an event which includes all three of it. So when she asked me to train her for 7 hours for a triathlon, I thought for a while and then I really thought if I could spend those 7 hours to train her. And I apologized to her, I'm sorry, I'm busy and I have no time. But I gave her the pointers where she could go for that training and what she could do. I wanted her to be more self-reliant. I suggested her that she continues with the training. After having spoken to her, I reached home and I found that the water heater had broken and there was water all over the basement. I'm sure if any of you have encountered that situation, it's so frightening and such a mess to clean it up. And it took me 7 to 8 hours to clean up the entire mess and then have things sorted as it was earlier. After having fixed that issue, I just realized that when my friend came and asked me for 7 hours of my time, I denied saying that I had no time. But yet, when there was water all over the basement, I made sure that I had time to clean it up. That situation taught me that it's all about our priorities. Like when there was water all over the basement, I could not say I would not clean it and just stay as is. So I had to go ahead and address that issue. Likewise, when I say I have no time for XYZ task, let's say it's some 3 tasks, I have no time. That just means I do not want to do XYZ as it's not my priority. So that is what was the thing that I realized that day. But do we all have enough time to do things that we really want to do? Do you think we have time to do things that we really want to do? Yes, I think most of them feel that they do have time. All of us have 24 hours a day. Let's just do a quick math. Let's say if we have 24 hours a day, so for a week we have almost 168 hours. Let's say we all work 8 hours. Okay, how much of it goes to work and how much of it goes to sleep? Let's say 8 hours a day we work and 8 hours a day we'll sleep. That's just a random number. So you will end up spending 40 hours working and 56 hours sleeping. With all this, you still have 72 hours left up with you to do other set of tasks, like whatever interests you. Maybe training for a 5K run, or going for a music class, or volunteering for a CSR activity. Anything that interests you. Looks like the crowd is not happy enough to hear that they just work 40 hours. Let's say, okay, they are very hardworking, so let me put 10 more hours just to make them smile. Okay, now I can see a few smiles. So let's say 10, you still have 62 hours. So 62 hours is really good amount of time to do anything that you want to do. Probably if you're thinking of preparing for a test, I've been thinking about it from a long time, but I always say, I have no time. I really don't know where all my time goes, but that's what I keep telling. So even with those 62 hours, if we use it judiciously, I think we can do a lot more things and try and help others who seek for help. Like a lot of times there are people around us who might need a little of your time, but then we end up saying we have no time. Usually it so happens that small moments are the most powerful ones. You might just use that couple of minutes helping somebody, but it's of a great use. That time goes in as a very good usage of time, because at the end of it, you're helping somebody who is in real need. Usually we tend to miss all small bits of time. Let's say we have time traveling from home to office. How many of you take office cabs? And what's the maximum amount of time that you spend in cab?
2 hours.
Yeah, so even I also spend almost 2.5 hours to 3 hours every day traveling from home to office. So during this time, I chose to read something wonderful each day. So that has made my traveling experience much better. So this is one way wherein I thought I should go ahead and change the way I use time in the cab. But definitely I can't sit and run in the cab. That I can't do. Whatever I can do within that available spot, I try doing that. So this is what I've learned from this experience wherein every time, yes, it's easy to say that I have no time, but time is very elastic. It can stretch to accommodate all that you want to put in it. You can definitely use it for all that matters to you. When you focus what matters to you, you can definitely lead a life happily and the way you want with the amount of time that you have. There's a famous quote which says that ordinary people, they actually spend time, but then extraordinary people use time. So let us all use the time. So going forward, if somebody comes to you and asks for help, please do not say no time. Just be on time to help that person. Thank you.